Do all of the images you export from Revit look like they have been rendered on a potato computer? Today, I'm going to be showing you how you can avoid this and get crisp, high-quality images exported out of Revit every time. I'm going to be showing you an example of a rendering on a non-rendering perspective view and then also a plan view. So we're going to be covering all of our bases. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to all of the interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit. This is the office building model that I'm going to be using for this presentation. The whole course on how to create this building and project documentation is on my website, so you can check that out. But now let's talk about exporting high quality images out of Revit from this model. So first, let's talk about rendering views. So I'm just going to open up this 3D view, and let's say we want to render this view, and we want to make sure that the image size is the best possible size, so we don't get a pixelated image, but we also don't get an image that's way too large. So what do we need to do first? Well, first we need to set up our 3D view. So you want to select this crop region, and then once you've selected the crop region, you go here to size crop. This will open up the crop size region menu, and here you need to adjust the width and the height of this rendering. Now, if you want to keep the proportions, and in most cases you are going to want to keep the proportions, you want to check here scale, and then you can just adjust either the width or the height. And if you want to actually change this number, you can just drag out these dots here and change that inside of the view. So if you're going to be printing this, you just want to make sure that this matches the size of paper or the size of this image on paper once printed. So here, if I want to print this, let's say on an A4 piece of paper or a letter size paper, what I would do is I would just go with perhaps 300 millimeters for the width, and then I would hit apply. This would update the height as well, keeping the same scaled proportions, and this will make sure that once printed on this size of paper, I've entered the size, it's going to look okay. Okay, then I can click OK, and now let's start the rendering process. So I'm just going to go here to the view menu and then click on render. This will open up the rendering menu, and then this is important. This is where a lot of confusion comes from, because we have this quality setting and we can set it up here, but this doesn't actually control the size of the image. So basically, the quality is referring to things like shadows, like light, reflection, transparency of glass, and so on. It's not referring to the actual image size and how pixelated it is. So for example, you want to look at this as, let's say you're taking a photo with an old Nokia brick. Well, that's going to be realistic because you're taking a photo of something realistic. However, it is going to be very pixelated. So these are the realism settings. So how realistic do you want your rendering to be? And then this is the size. So how pixelated or how clear you want it to be. So we want to make sure that our settings are done correctly here. So that means you want to set this on printer, and then for the size, you want to go with 300 dpi. This will give you the best print quality. You can go to 600, but it's not necessary, just because you're not going to be able to see that when printed, just because printers really don't get that kind of quality, at least not the regular ones. And then you also have screen if you want to print this or show this on screens only. And then here you would see the size of pixels. So you just want to check where that's going to be shown and what pixel sizes you're looking for. And then if you want to change this, you would have to go back to crop settings and change that again. So here I'm just going to set this to printer, and now I can render. For the size, I tend to go with medium. This usually gives me the quickest rendering time with an okay quality. And this is the end result. So I'm just going to save this to project. Let's call it this. That's perfectly fine. And now I'm going to escape out of here and let's find that rendering. So it's going to be here under renderings. And I think that's this one, number 3. There we go. And now we can check if I zoom in. As you can see, I think we have decent quality. This is quite a large screen. So of course, when we zoom in, we are going to get some pixelation. But overall, yeah, the size is perfectly fine. And then if you want to export this, you could have done that from the rendering menu, or you can go here to File, Export, and then go down to Images and Animation, find Image, Export. And then here, you would just want to make sure that you set this to Zoom 2 and type out 100. And then for the raster image quality, go with 300, just like we did previously in the rendering menu. And now when you click OK, that's basically going to save that image in that perfect size. Now, moving forward, let's talk about a non-render view like this one. So for this, if you want to have a perspective view, again, you would want to make sure that the crop size is set correctly. In this case, we know it is because we have already done it. So the next step is just to make a few minor adjustments. So I like to go here to Visual Styles and then find Graphic Display Options. And here I like to check on the smooth lines with anti-aliasing. When I hit Apply and OK, you can see it just smooths out the lines so we don't get any of that pixelation. And now we're pretty much done and ready. I can go here to File, Export, go down to Images and Animation, find Image. And then here, again, you want to keep this to zoom to 100% of actual size and raster quality, raster image quality to 300. And again, I would click OK. And it's going to ask me, OK, I need to rename this probably. Click OK again. And yeah, that's going to save that image. Now, finally, let's talk about exporting things like floor plans, because that's where you can also get issues. So let's open up our floor plan like this, and then I'm just going to turn on the crop region visible so we can see where that is. So of course, you want to make sure that this is set up correctly. So here, I'm just going to bring it in as close as possible to the model. Just like that. Okay, so now let's say you're happy with this. So here we don't have the option for a crop region, just because if we go to size crop, it's going to give us the size of that image, and this is going to be according to scale. So here we can see that the overall size is 785 by 568. So that's okay, or it's not okay, depending on what you're trying to do. But usually, if you're just exporting this and you just want to print it at a certain size, but you don't want to change the scale, what you can do then is just cancel out of here. And then again, just go to File, go to Export, go down, Images and Animation, Image. And then here, what you can do is you can go to Zoom to 100% of the actual image size, raster quality set to 300. And now when I click OK, and let's just change the name here as well so we don't get any issues, click OK. And now that's going to export that image. And then we can see what the end result is. So once we open up these images, you can see this is the result. And then I can zoom in quite far enough, and I can see that this is actually really high quality, or the size is really large, so we can see everything in this image. Next, let's move over to our sheet, or to the floor plan. So here, again, you can see that the image quality, just judging from a distance, is already good, just because all of the lines are quite thin. But then as we zoom in, you can see we're not really losing all that much quality. So everything is very visible and very readable. And this is how you actually want these to look if you have to export sheets as images or JPEGs, PNGs, and so on. Moving forward, let's go and take a look at this model. Again, this looks really, really good for a non-rendered model. I think this is perfect. I mean, when we zoom in, again, we can see if we zoom in far enough, of course, we're going to get pixelation or visible pixels. But overall, like this, I think this looks really, really good. So there we go. If you want really high quality images, just follow these steps and you're always going to get perfect results. If you want to get access to all of my Revit project files, like this office building, but also 500 other files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.